Hello everyone. In this example, in this video, we're going to talk about how to factor expressions involving negative exponents. So, suppose I give you something like this, x raised to the negative 6th power plus 7x raised to the negative 3rd power plus 10. So you would factor this the same way that you would factor a normal polynomial of the of type x to the 6th plus x to the 3rd plus 10. Okay? You would treat it the same way as a normal polynomial. This is not a polynomial, but you can still factor it the same way as you would this polynomial right here. Right? So you would use reverse FOIL method technique. So you would have the x's as your first terms in each parenthesis sequence. So then you would have to have the same power for the two x's in the beginning, because you want your middle term to contain x to the negative 3rd power. So, and at the same time, if you have x to the negative 3rd power, notice that when you multiply the bases, you will sum up their powers, the exponents, right? And the exponent sum will be minus 3 plus minus 3, which gives you minus 6. So you kill two birds with one stone that way, right? Now, the remaining terms are calculated based off of this number and this number, the 10 and 7. So factors of 10, factors meaning they will multiply themselves to give you 10. And when, as a sum, these factors should give you 7. Okay, so when multiplied, the factors give you 10, and when added together, they give you 7. What are those factors? They are 5 and 10, right? Because 5 and 2. 5 times 2 is 10, and 5 plus 2 is 7, right? So it's going to be plus 5 and plus 2. Okay, and if you want to check this back, you would have x minus 3 multiplied by x to the negative 3rd. Using the FOIL method, right? This is what we're doing, plus 2x negative 3 plus 5x to the negative 3rd power plus 10. So you would have, the bases are the same, so you just add the powers, x minus 3 minus 3 plus the like terms, right? They have the same variable raised to the same exponent, so you just combine the like terms by adding the coefficients, so it's going to be plus 7x raised to the negative 3rd power plus 10. So that gives you x to the negative 6 plus 7x to the negative 3rd plus 10. Okay? Let's provide one more example. It's a slightly more complicated one. Suppose I give you x to the negative 1 half power minus, this time, 13x to the negative 1 fourth power plus 40. How would you take care of this polynomial? Expression involving negative exponents, right? It's not a polynomial. Okay. So how would you do this? Well, you will use the reverse FOIL method technique again. Write down your x's. Now think of the powers that you would use, and these powers must be the same, right? Because there are three terms, so this calls for the standard reverse FOIL method technique to be used. So let's use this negative 1, 4 and see what we have. So negative 1, 4 and then negative 1, 4. Notice that when you multiply the x's, you will add their respective exponents. So you will have negative 1, 4 minus negative 1, 4. Well, negative 1, 4 plus minus 1, 4, which gives you negative 1 over 4 minus 1 over 4. That gives you negative 2 over 4. Now, negative 2 over 4, so what I mean is this. So negative 1 over 4 times x to the negative 1 over 4 is simply adding their power, so that gives you negative 2 over 4, and that's reduced as x to the negative 1 half. Bingo, right? So we satisfied this first term by choosing the correct first terms in each parenthesis. Now we have to think of factors of 40, and remember, you're dealing with a minus sign, minus 13, so you have to think of negative factors. Two factors that are both negative, when multiplied, gives you a positive, which is good, but when add it will give you a negative sign, which is also correct. Okay, because when you subtract from a negative sign, you still get a negative sign. Okay, that's the rule of algebra. So let's have factors of 40. What factors of 40 would you choose? Well, I would choose negative 5 and negative 8, right? Because negative 5 times negative 8 gives you positive 40, and negative 5 minus negative 8 gives you negative 13. Okay, so we can choose in any order. We can write x minus 5 and x minus 8. And once again, we already checked the first part of the reverse of the FOIL method, which gave us the first correct term of x to the negative 1/2 power. Everything else should be really easy because you will combine the like terms in your outer and inner steps of the FOIL method, and then the last term will give you positive 40. So this checks. Okay? See you in my next video. Thanks for watching.